Chapter 8, Hypothesis Testing. In 8.3, we're going to test a claim about a mean. Testing a claim about a population mean is one of the most important methods presented in the book. Part 1 of this section deals with the very realistic and commonly used case in which the population standard deviation sigma is not known. We will not cover Part 2. The objective is to use a formal hypothesis test to test a claim about a population mean mu. N is the sample size, x bar is the sample mean, s is the sample standard deviation, mu sub x bar is the population mean. The requirements that must be met are the sample is a simple random sample, and either or both of these conditions are satisfied, the population is normally distributed, or n is greater than 30. The test statistic is a t-test and calculated using the formula you see. P-values. Using technology or use the student t-distribution table A3 with degrees of freedom given by df equals n minus 1. Critical values. Use the student t-distribution table A3 with degrees of freedom given by df equals n minus 1. To find the sample, the single number p-value, use this online calculator and look for the t-distribution and then p-value calculator for student t-test. Note about finding p-values. You'll be using the online calculator included in the previous slide to find single number p-values for some problems while completing your work at home. However, you will not have access to this online calculator during on-campus testing. Therefore, you will need to learn how to find an interval of p-values for a t-test statistic using table A3. Instructions on how to do that are included in this lesson. We will use both the p-value method and the critical value method to test hypotheses about the mean with sigma unknown. We will not cover the cases where sigma is known. The requirement of normality, or n is greater than 30. If the original population is not itself normally distributed, we use the condition n equals is greater than 30 for justifying use of the normal distribution. Sample sizes of 15 to 30 are sufficient if the population has a distribution that is not far from normal. In this text, we use the simplified criterion of n greater than 30 as justification for treating the distribution of sample means as a normal distribution, regardless of how far the distribution departs from a normal distribution. There are important properties of the student t-distribution that you need to remember. The student t-distribution is different for different sample sizes. The student t-distribution has the same general bell shape as the standard normal distribution. Its wider shape reflects the greater variability that is expected when S is used instead to estimate sigma. The student t-distribution has a mean of t is 0. The standard deviation of the student t-distribution varies with the sample size and is greater than 1. As the sample size n gets larger, the student t-distribution gets closer to the standard normal distribution. There are 8 steps to the hypothesis test, very similar to what you did in the last section in testing hypotheses about proportions. In this section, we're testing hypotheses about means. We identify the claim to be tested and express it in symbol form. Given the symbol form, that must be true when the original claim is false, opposite of the claim. Write the null and alternative hypotheses in symbol form. Select your significance level. Identify the relative statistic. In this case, we're going to be using t. Then, if you're going to be using the p-value method, you use the formula to calculate the test statistic. You may have to find sample statistics using methods from previous chapters. Find the area corresponding to the calculated test statistic. Know if the test is a one-tailed or two-tailed test. Read table A3 for an interval of values. Use the online calculator to find a single number p-value. Draw a graph showing the calculated test statistic and p-value. Make a decision. Compare to the significance level, alpha is 0.05. Reject H sub O if the p-value is less than or equal to alpha, and fail to reject H sub O if the p-value is greater than alpha. Then write the conclusion in a complete sentence addressing the original claim. If you're doing the critical value method, then you're going to use the formula to calculate the test statistic Find the critical value or values associated with the significance level to determine the critical region or regions. Draw the graph and place the values. Make a decision. Reject H sub O or fail to reject H sub O based on the whether the calculated test statistic falls in the critical region or not. Then you're going to write the conclusion in a complete sentence addressing the original claim. Here's an example, adult sleep. The author obtained times of sleep for randomly selected adult subjects included in the National Health and Nutrition Examinations study, and those times hours are listed below. Here are the unrounded statistics for the sample. N is 12, X bar was found to be 6.8 with a repeating 3 hours, and S was found, the standard deviation for the sample was found to be 1.9924984 rounded number of hours. A common recommendation is that adults should sleep between 7 hours and 9 hours each night. Use the p-value method with a 0.05 significance level to test the claim that the mean amount of sleep for adults is less than 7 hours. The requirement check. The sample is simple random and the second requirement is that the population is normally distributed or n is greater than 30. Since n is 12, which doesn't exceed 30, we have to determine whether the sample data appear to be from a normally distributed population. We look at the histogram and check the normal quantile plot, and they both appear that, along with the apparent absence of outliers, it indicates that the sample appears to be from a population with a distribution approximately normal. So both requirements are satisfied. The claim that the mean amount of adult sleep is less than 7 hours becomes mu is less than 7 hours. Note that it's mu because we're testing a mean hypothesis in this section. The alternative to the original claim is mu is greater than or equal to 7. Because the statement mu is less than 7 hours does not contain the condition of equality, it becomes the alternative hypothesis H sub 1. The null hypothesis H sub O is the statement that mu is equal to 7 hours. Null hypothesis and alternative hypotheses are given. As specified in the statement of the problem, the significance level is 0.05. Because the claim is made about the population mean mu, the sample statistic most relevant to the test is the sample mean X bar, and we use the T distribution. Sample statistics they calculated for us were given originally, and they're used to calculate T. T is found to be in the formula negative 0.290. We are going to use the online calculator danielsoper.com StatCalc T distribution p-value calculator for a student T test to find the p-value for the t that we calculated. So if I go back, the t is equal to negative 0.290, and this is a left-tailed test. So if I go to this site, see if I can make it go there. Go, it won't go there. Hang on a second. I've navigated to the site, I scroll down, find t-distribution, and then I want the p-value calculator for a student t-test. I need to know the degrees of freedom and the t-value. Well, the degrees of freedom was, n is 12, so the degrees of freedom is 11, and t is negative 0.290. Degrees of freedom is 11, and t is negative 0.290. And select calculate. If it is a one-tailed right-tailed test, I use 0.611. If it's a one-tailed left-tailed test, I use 0.388. And if it's a two-tailed test, I use 0.777. With the alternative hypothesis, I know that It is a left-tailed test. Therefore, I'm going to use the p is equal to 0.3877. This was from the site, and notice that it does match the p-value. Table A3, which is the table that you're going to have available on the test, isn't going to give you as precise a p-value. So we have to read the table in order to determine what the p-value range or interval of numbers would be based on what we have. So if I use table A3, keep in mind that it's designed for positive values of t and right tail values areas only, but left tail areas correspond to the same t values with negative sign. The previous example is a left-tailed test with a test statistic of t is negative 0.290 and a sample size of n is 12, so the number of degrees of freedom is 11. Using the test statistic of negative 0.290 in table A3, examine the values of t in the row for df equals 11 to see that 0.290 is less than all of the listed t values in the row, which indicates that the area in the left tail below the test statistic of t is negative 2.90 is greater than 0.10. In this case, table A3 allows us to conclude that the p-value is greater than 0.10, but technology provided the p-value of 0.3887. With the p-value greater than 0.10, the conclusions are the same as in the previous example. If I look at the table and go through the same discussion, I'm going to go through table A3. I'm going to look at row 11, and I'm going to decide where a t of negative 0.290, which positive is what the t table tells me, it would be to the extreme right of this set of t values. So for row 11, the 2.90t that I found would be over here. If I go to the top of the chart, because this is a one-tailed test, notice that the p-values increase as you move from left to right. Therefore, the p-value for a t of 0.290 would be over here, which would be a value greater than 0.10. Because the p-value of 0.3887 is greater than the significance level of alpha's 0.05, we fail to reject the null hypothesis. Therefore, we conclude there is not sufficient evidence to support the claim that the mean amount of adult sleep is less than 7 hours.